So you were just diagnosed with multiple sclerosis. What now? Well, I'm Dr. Mitzi Joi Williams, a neurologist and MS specialist, and I'm so glad to be here with my friends from Can Do MS to tell you what your diagnosis means and how you can live well with MS. When someone is diagnosed with MS, the amount of information can often be overwhelming, so it's important to at least recognize and understand the basics. Number one, MS is an autoimmune disease, meaning the immune system, the part of the body that normally attacks viruses and bacteria, gets confused and attacks a good part of the body. The part of the body that's affected is the central nervous system, which includes the brain, the spinal cord, and the optic nerves, which affect vision. MS is actually an overactivity of the immune system and not suppression of the immune system, which many people mistakenly think. The damage that occurs to the myelin, which is the coating of the nerves in the central nervous system. And when those signals are interrupted, kind of like if there's damage to a wire or a cord, it can result in certain symptoms or certain parts of the body not functioning like they're supposed to. When your doctors look at your MRIs with you, there are certain things that they look for. When we see those white spots or lesions, it indicates that the myelin, that coating of the nerves, has been removed, and that's why we see those white spots in its place. It's also important to recognize that every white spot does not necessarily mean that there's permanent damage there, and every white spot does not necessarily cause symptoms. However, the accumulation of damage over time can cause problems later on in life with MS or very late in diagnosis, whereas they may not have caused issues very early on. It's also important to recognize that there are several types of MS. There is relapsing remitting MS, which the majority of people are diagnosed with, about 85%, and that's where you have symptoms that come and go. Also, there is secondary progressive MS, where people kind of steadily worsen after they have started off with relapsing remitting MS. And then finally, there's primary progressive MS, where people may have symptoms that just slowly worsen over time, and they don't really have those relapses like we see with relapsing remitting disease. One of the most common questions my patients ask me is, what are the most common symptoms of MS, or what should I be looking out for? When people are initially diagnosed, they very commonly have optic neuritis, which is loss of vision in one eye or the other eye. They may also have symptoms like numbness and tingling on one side of the body or the other, or weakness. Sometimes these symptoms can actually be mistaken for stroke. I think it's also important to recognize that there are many what we call silent symptoms of MS, symptoms that can be very disabling, but that people may not readily recognize as symptoms of the disease. One of them is fatigue. People can have very severe fatigue that actually can impact their daily function. People can also have cognitive changes, meaning difficulty with their thinking, whether that is difficulty processing or problems with concentration or even short-term memory in some cases. And then one other very common silent symptom is either bowel or bladder dysfunction, where people may have to go to the restroom a lot, or they may not be able to control when they have to use the restroom. It's also important to recognize that these symptoms can be unpredictable, and just because you feel well does not mean that there's not continued damage affecting your brain and spinal cord. So that's why it's so important to follow up with your neurologist or your team on a regular basis to make sure that your symptoms are being well controlled. Often people ask me, well, Dr. Mitzi, what's going to happen to me? What can I expect in the future? The first thing that we know about MS is that if you've seen one person with MS, you've seen one person with MS, because everyone is so different. The way their symptoms start, the way they change or don't change over time is very unique to each individual. One thing that you can expect is that there are challenges. There's the fear of the unknown, which affects many people who are newly diagnosed, especially those who have symptoms that they may not have fully recovered from. What will I look like? What will my future be in terms of my job, in terms of my employment, in terms of my family responsibilities? And all those things are a very normal part of the process. Also, it's normal to go through a grieving process, especially if you have symptoms that did not resolve and affect your function and your ability to work or interact with others. I often recommend that my patients see a counselor to deal with these things as they are newly diagnosed and adjusting to their new normal. It's also very important to follow up with your doctor on a regular basis to talk about the symptoms that you're having, the things that are very visible for us to see, but also those things that are going on under the surface that you may not address with family members, such as mood, anxiety, depression, things like that. Also, I think one of the most important things is an expectation that you are a key player in your overall health. And if you're watching this video, you're already starting to do the work to learn about your diagnosis, to learn about how you can live your best life with multiple sclerosis, and educating yourself and your family so that you can be your own best advocate.